not really good because there was some anxiety within the sectors of the British in terms of persons were not able to reach their families with relief cargo. But now that the ship is coming, I'm sure lots of persons will be looking forward to receiving things from their families, especially from the UK.
Okay, there are rumors around that people are stealing stuff on the port. What can you say about that?
Well, no. Again, you know, I've heard all sorts of things happening on the port, which is not correct. Clearly, immediately after Mario, there were lots of people coming in to pick up different stuff direct from vessels and so on. But that has since been regularized, and you need to come to the port, you need to ensure that you're doing business at the port, and the regular port requirements are there now. So, this myth of people missing things in the port, no, that's not
okay. So our barrels being searched, I know people getting their stuff free, the customs officers just searching the barrel, because you know those times people can be sending illegal items. So what are the measures to safeguard these things?
Well, the measures to safeguard these things is customs obviously is seeking to protect the state from these negative aspects, as you highlighted, and so they have their various means of doing that. They are in fact scrutinizing everything that comes in using various means that they have, including canine units that they have. So everything to protect the country is being done so that no illegal weapons or other activities can come into the state, because we just came from Mario and we could be vulnerable.
Yes.
And so we want to make sure that we keep the state as safe as possible.
So what are the port times? What are the times now the port is
the
operating?
The port times is operating Monday to Friday, 8 to 4, so that persons can come to pick up their cargo. We will make determinations as we go along on a Saturday, where we can take it from 9 to 3. It depends on the volume of individual cargo that's there. We're also working with the truckers, and we go up to 7 o'clock Monday to Friday with the truckers. Up to 7 o'clock at night, because the business community obviously wants to restock and wants to be able to get the goods faster. So in an effort to do that, we are trying to facilitate them.
I understood that there is a Dasco page. If people want to know if the containers are offloaded, they can check the Dasco page.
Yes, on the Facebook page, we're trying to put in the numbers, because people were, you know, calling and trying to figure out what numbers were available. Also on the security house, when people were to walk up to the security house, we have a board where we put the latest numbers that are de-staffed. And we're trying to ensure that we can ask the agents as well to notify persons, because the agents are notified when the container is de-staffed. So they can tell their people as well to come to collect the cargo at the port.
That's good.
It's a lot of pressure for us, but we're trying our best to see how we can handle the situation.
So what else do you have to say to the public?
Well, what I'd like to say to the public is we would want them to exercise patience with us. We know that, you know, your family may have sent a generator or two to you and you want it the next day. But we also suffered. We had a problem where we suffered and a number of days our equipment, major pieces of equipment broke down. And so we lost a few work days without these pieces of equipment. And when you have a container stacked 4 high, you don't have any equipment to put it down, and you have both pieces of equipment have gone down at the same time, then definitely there is a problem. So we just want we have them back up now and running. So we just want the public to bear a little patience with us. We're trying to do everything we can do to bring things at a faster rate to them. And we're doing so, given the challenges that we have, but it's improving as we go along. We have electricity from Domlek at the Woodbridge Bay Port, the ferry terminal. We just connected electricity there as well. Hopefully we should be getting Keenfield Airport connected to electricity. And we are in fact making strides in terms of doing that.
Okay.
And then we are looking at the other airport. Obviously, it's out, way out in the northeast. But we're running on generators, and we're hoping that we can continue to provide the public with the service that is there.
Okay, well, I want to thank you for talking to MONews, and I wish you all the best. I know it's a very big task, and people need their stuff, and I know it's going to be a long, long process. I want to wish you all the best.
Yeah. Right, thanks for giving me that opportunity so I can speak to the public. We know that independence is over, Christmas is coming. People are looking forward to their family sending stuff for them. So you send the stuff. We'll try to speed up the process. If we have to work extra hours or odd hours to be able to do that, we will do it. We just want to make sure that we can deliver.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Have a nice day.
Right.
So this is MO News. I just spoke to Mr. Badwill. You heard him. They're asking you all to be patient with the ports. I too, I'm expecting some cargo, 2 weeks now. So I understand. So be patient. This is MO News Live from the ports.